بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه ما بعد. A few months ago, there was a massive fire in California. You're aware of the forest fires. And after that, a lot of pictures started coming out of the before and after pictures. Before, how green, how beautiful the forest was. And then when the fire came and left, completely charred, scarred, charcoal. You also see these before-after photos so many times. There's a natural disaster, or sometimes even a human disaster, such as the rainforest of Brazil. We find before and after. Before, we find luscious and green and beautiful. And then, overnight, it is as if it is completely destroyed. This image, which is a reality of our life and existence, is used by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in multiple parables in the Quran. Today we're going to do two verses that have the exact same phrase, but each one has a slight nuanced difference. The first of them, Surah Yunus, verse 24. Allah says in the Quran, إِنَّمَا مَثَلُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا كَمَاءٍ أَنْزَلْنَاهُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ. The similitude of this life of this world, the example, the parable of the life of this world is like water that we have sent down from the heavens. مَعِنْ أَنزَلْنَا مِنَ السَّمَاءِ فَاخْتَلَطَ بِهِ نَبَاتُ الْأَرْضِ. This water comes down and it mixes with the plants, the soils, the seeds in this earth. Right? What happens then? Then Allah Azza wa Jal brings forth فَاخْتَلَطَ بِهِ نَبَاتُ الْأَرْضِ مِمَّا يَأْكُلُ النَّاسُ وَالْأَنْعَامُ. Then vegetation comes. This vegetation is eaten by both humans and by animals, right? حَتَّى إِذَا أَخَذَتِ الْأَوْضُ زُخْرُفَهَا. Then, when this earth appears to be at its pinnacle, وَزَيَّنَتْ, and it is so beautiful, وَظَنَّ أَهْلُهَا أَنَّهُمْ قَادِرُونَ عَلَيْهَا. And the owners of this garden, they think that they are in control of everything. أَتَاهَا أَمْرُنَا لَيْلًا أَوْ نَهَارًا. Instantaneously, either night or during the day, our command comes. فَجَعَلْنَاهَا حَصِيدًا كَأَنْ لَمْ تَغْنَ بِالْأَمْسِ. And we make it as if it was no crops. حَصِيد means it is completely destroyed. As if it did not even exist yesterday. So Allah Azza wa Jal gives us a parable of this world. And in Surah Al-Kahf, verse 45, a very similar parable, we'll be doing both of them today. Allah says in the Quran that وَضْرِبْ لَهُ مَثَلَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا كَمَاءٍ أَنْزَلْنَاهُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ فَاخْتَرَطَ بِهِ نَبَاتُ الْأَرْضِ. This is exactly the same phrase as in Surah Yunus, but then this verse goes somewhere else. فَأَصْبَحَ هَشِيمًا تَدْرُوهُ الرِّيَاحِ. Then it becomes like dried hay that the wind can blow away. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ مُقْتَدِرًا. And indeed, Allah is capable of all things. Now, in both of these phrases, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala compares the life of this world with water that comes down from the heavens. It mixes with the soil. It mixes with the seeds. And then it produces beautiful vegetation. It produces vegetation that dazzles the eyes. Vegetation and plants of different varieties. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, either my command comes or nature takes its course. Either an act of God or death itself. That's the difference. Surah Yunus is an act of God. Surah Kahf is death. Either of them to come, and then what happens? That garden becomes like nothing. So Allah Azza wa Jal gives us this beautiful parable, and there's so many benefits. First and foremost, Allah compares the origin of life. He compares it with water coming from the skies, and our life begins with water. All life begins with water. And Allah says, this is the example of this world as well. Secondly, the mixing together. This is the mixing that happens of all human beings when they are formed. And also, thirdly, the coming forth of different vegetations. Allah is saying, people grow up differently. They become different things. Not everybody's the same. That's what Allah is saying. Some of the fruits and vegetables, even humans eat them. Others, only animals eat them. There's an indirect reference that there's nobility and there's the things that are not so noble. Some human beings become very noble. Others, they act like animals. People are different variety. And then what happens? Then as the child grows, becomes different, then a sense of arrogance comes in many people. A sense of seeing this beauty, controlling some aspect of creation. Now you have wealth. Now you have status. Now you have the possessions of this world. Now you have families. So now you feel a sense of eternality. Oh, this life is good. And then before they know it, either an act of God comes, which is anything that can happen. A sudden death or a punishment or a communal disaster or COVID. This is أتاها أمرها ليلاً أو نهاراً. Morning or evening. Nobody can predict when that death is going to come. Morning or evening. You don't know. It's not in your schedule. It's not in your calendar when that punishment comes or when the angel of death comes. Instantaneously, the person goes from controlling all of this to all of a sudden having absolutely nothing. Or death comes to you. And generations go on. And so all that legacy that you had, all of that dwellings that you built, all of the possessions that you had, it becomes like hay. It used to be green. It used to be golden. It used to be bright and luscious. Now, where is it gone? And subhanAllah, dear brothers and sisters, here we are in this particular year, in this particular era. Where are your ancestors? Where is your grandfather? Where is the father before him? Where are the thousands and hundreds of thousands of generations that are directly related to you? Your own ancestry, where are they now? Where are the buildings that they developed? Where are the families that they lived, loved, and cherished and played with? Where are the possessions that they owned? Where are they all now? All of it is in the hands of other people, and you don't even know the names of your own ancestors. فَجَعَلْنَاهَا حَصِيدًا كَأَنْ لَمْ تَغْنَ بِالْأَمْسِ. It's like the hay that goes in the wind and the wind scatters it everywhere. Allah is saying, don't you guys think? Don't you guys realize? You too are going to be that hay. You too are going to be gone. Right now you see the garden. It's luscious. It's beautiful. Right now everything is so bright. But learn from the cycle of nature and learn from the cycle of history. Just like they left with nothing, not even a trace is left. And even those massive civilizations that left certain traces here and there, what do we really know about them? How many of their names do we really know? They might have left the pyramids, they might have left their massive architectural structures, but the people in them, where are they? What is their legacy? What are their names? We have no knowledge. All of it is gone. فَجَعَلْنَاهَا عَصِيدًا كَأَنْ لَمْ تَغْنَ بِالْأَمْسِ. As if they never even existed. And then Allah says, these are the ayat we want you to think about. In Surah Yunus, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala follows this verse with a very beautiful verse. وَاللَّهُ يَدْعُ إِلَىٰ دَارِ السَّلَامِ. Allah is calling you to the abode of peace. That is the ultimate abode. Don't be deluded by this dunya. وَاللَّهُ يَدْعُ إِلَىٰ دَارِ السَّلَامِ. That is the abode. In Surah Al-Kahf, Allah follows this verse with another beautiful reminder. الْمَالُ وَالْبَنُونَ زِينَةُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَالْبَاقِيَاتُ الصَّالِحَاتُ خَيْرٌ عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ ثَوَابًا وَخَيْرٌ أَمَلًا. Yes, money and wealth makes life beautiful, no question about it. But they're only of this world. They're not going to remain. What will remain? وَالْبَاقِيَاتُ الصَّالِحَاتُ. By the way, this is another interesting point. Allah mentions the adverb before, or the adjective before the noun. وَالْبَاقِيَاتُ الصَّالِحَاتُ. Technically, it should be وَالصَّالِحَاتُ الْبَاقِيَاتُ. The good deeds that remain. That's how you're going to say the good deeds that remain. But Allah flips it around. وَالْبَاقِيَاتُ الصَّالِحَاتُ. To emphasize, your good deeds are what is eternal. The eternal things which are the good deeds. وَالْبَاقِيَاتُ الصَّالِحَاتُ خَيْرٌ عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ ثَوَابًا وَخَيْرٌ أَمَلًا. That will get you a reward from Allah, and you should have more hope in your good deeds. So both of these verses, and there are actually a few more, but I wanted to concentrate on these two. They emphasize the life of this world as being transient, temporary, beautiful, alluring, something that is deceiving, something that is luscious and green for a period of time, and then khalas, it will go on, and life goes on, and your life as well will move on to the next phase. So from these verses, we should derive that beautiful benefit. Do not be deceived by the life of this world. Do not become deluded. You are not here forever. No one is here forever. Our Imam recited in today's recitation, وَمَا جَعَلْنَا لِبَشَرٍ مِّن قَبْلِكَ الْخُلْدِ. That كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ. That nobody has lived forever. Every person will taste death. So let us take heed of these two parables and do not become deceived by the greenery and the lushnesses of this world. Enjoy this world, but our ultimate reality is the next life. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of the people of success of the next life.